Shot, one opportunity, seize everything you ever wanted, one moment, did you capture it, or just let it slip, yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy, there's vomit on his sweater already, mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs, but he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down, the whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out, he's choking how, everybody's choking now, the clock's run out, time's up, over, plow, snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity, oh, there goes gravity, he choke, he's so mad, but he won't give up. He won't have it, he knows his whole back to these ropes. It don't matter, he's dope. He knows that, but he's broke. He's so stagnant, he knows when he goes back to this mobile home. That's when it's back to the lab again, yo. This old rhapsody better go capture this moment and hope it don't do it. Lose his mouth in the music the moment you own it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better lose his mouth in the music the moment you own it. Taking, make me king as we move toward a new world order. A normal life is boring, but superstardom's close to postmortem. It only grows harder, homie grows hotter. He blows, it's all over. These hoes is all on him. Coast to coast shows, he's known as the Globetrotter. Lonely roads, God only knows he's grown farther from home. He's no father. He goes home and barely knows his own daughter. But hold your nose, cause here goes the cold water. These hoes don't. Tear this motherfucking roof off like two dogs' cage. I was playing in the beginning, the mood all changed. I've been chewed up and spit out and booed off stage. But I kept rhyming and stepped right in the next cipher. Best believe somebody's paying the Pied Piper. All the pain inside amplified by the fact that I can't get by with my 9 to 5. And I can't provide the right type of life for my family. Cause man, these goddamn food stamps don't buy diapers. And there's no movie, there's no Mackay Pfeiffer. And these times are so hard, and it's getting even harder trying to feed and water my seed. Plus, see the thought I caught up between being a father and a prima donna. Baby mama drama screaming on her too much for me to want to stay in one spot. Another damn monotony's gotten me to the point I'm like a snail. I've got to formulate a plot or end up in
World War II films in the movie market this year. Enemy at the Gates was just released a while back, and Pearl Harbor will explode into theaters this month. Both have big guns to win their battles, but Master of the Game shows how the mind can win your freedom.
Hangar 3 inside Austin Studios is housing a log cabin, and inside is the film crew for Master of the Game.
Quiet, everybody.
And action.
Inspired by the film 12 Angry Men, a concentration camp escapee challenges his Nazi captors to a powerful mind game in which one person is left standing. It's not based on a true story, but the writer and actors hope that people walk away with a deeper understanding of why events such as these happened.
I was a little more interested in the psychological dynamics and mechanisms that are behind racism that motivate it. So I hope this digs a little deeper than that and exposes those dynamics.
Next up for the feature are industry screenings, film festivals, and hopefully a distribution deal, leading to an opportunity for this film to send its message.
There you go.
I'm really
Matt,
strong,
this is the first time!
Hey, it's a 8:45. Are you on?
Yeah.
Leave it on. That's when we drive by.
That's okay. Where it is!
There is a freaking line.
There is a freaking line in front of the theater, baby.
He's the star of a new film. It's the creation of a truly sensational new talent. He has been described as handsome, tough, talented, sexy, sensitive, dynamic, and brilliant. He's been compared to Brando, Newman, Pacino, and De Niro. He's been called a top contender for an Academy Award for the best movies of the year. 4 stars.
If you're just an actor, you go to all the auditions and you try to get good roles and you keep waiting around for somebody to hand you the role that you dream of. And I just thought to myself, you know, this one could take forever. As is the case with many actors, so I thought, you know, and you know your strengths and weaknesses better than anybody else. So you can actually design the character to bring out your best and kind of camouflage the worst. But I enjoy the complete storytelling process where you create the story and then you get to portray the character yourself. I mean, to me it's, I can't separate the two. What inspired me to write it, or how
inspired
I...
Inspired you, yeah, how you...
Yeah, there were a couple of things. First, I'm sure you all know, the 50s classic Oscar-winning 12 Angry Men. The concept fascinated me, that you could have so much drama and tension in one single location, relying mainly on dialogue. The second thing was this experiment that was done in the 60s, where a school teacher walked into the room one day and said, the blue-eyed kids are actually smarter than the brown-eyed kids. And observed for the next week that the blue-eyed kids started really acting superior and the brown-eyed kids started feeling an inferiority complex. Didn't do so well. We're hesitant to, you know, raise our hands and ask some questions and all that. And then the next week she came in and said, well, actually there was a mistake. The brown-eyed kids are actually smarter than the blue-eyed kids. And then observed for the following week that this time the brown-eyed kids started acting more superior, started actually beating on the blue-eyed kid and all that stuff. So I thought, you know, these feelings of superiority and inferiority can actually be imposed from outside by using an authority figure or like a rank, a title like the commander, or a social symbol like a uniform. And that's where I got the idea of role reversal.
Some people ask me if I wrote it for theater and then decided to do it on screen, but I actually intended it for film, but I would also love to do this on stage because of the single location, which was great.
How close was this to the way you originally envisioned it?
Well, it could have been much better. It went far beyond my wildest expectations, and I had high expectations, and it went far beyond that. And I owe this to the incredible filmmaking community here. I mean, you guys should give yourself a round of applause, because it was amazing.
Yeah.
Turkey and lives in LA, so this is, he never even been to Austin until first time to come up and shoot this film and sing with Alex. How did we find funding for the film?
Well, it was hard. I can tell you that much. But not much more. I mean, independent filmmaking, you just do everything you can to get it. I had to rob a bank first.
Really enjoyable.